So, ang itong pagbasahon, no? In Colossians chapter 2, verses 1 to 5. Colossians chapter 2, verses 1 to 5. I want you to know how much I am struggling for you and for those at Laodicea and for all who have not met me personally. Si Paul Lee, no? That's the reality. Next. My purpose is that they may be encouraged in heart and united in love, so that they may have the full riches of complete understanding, in order that they may know the mystery of God, namely Christ, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. I tell you this so that no one may deceive you by fine-sounding arguments. For though I am absent from you in body, I am present with you in spirit, and delight to see how orderly you are and how firm your faith in Christ is. Lord, we thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord. Now, si Paul nag-ampo sa simbahan sa Colossae, no? Akong ibasa ang history sa Colossae, sa church sa Colossae, naman ko yung mga naka-infiltrate sa simbahan ng mga false teachers. That's why money ang tono sa iyang isulti, sa iyang gi-message sa mga taga-Colossae. So, kanikaroon na kahihula ko ay we try to reflect it sa atuan sa simbahan. No? Dili man siguro mga false teachers ang naka-infiltrate sa ito. But nevertheless, Paul, Brother Paul, the Apostle Paul, has laid down something, no? Na pwede na ito siya dakpon and to imitate sa itong mga individual na itong kinabuhi and this body. No? Ingon niya din, I want you to know how much I am struggling. Kaya itong word na struggling, kung sumay niya itong may guta na. Struggle ba? So, dili na siya kwan. Dili na siya yung mga easy ba? No? Okay, there is a force that tries to motivate us to do more, to excel, to go beyond the strength of pulling us back because of our, number one, kanabitang mo pull us back are our own, kani, no? Kani mga panguna-una, what else? Kanabitang labi na kanamagbuhat ta sa buluhaton sa Ginoo, or we responded to the words sa Ginoo. In fact, ina-declare na na nga, for everyone who leads righteous living will really encounter difficulties. No, not yung mga opposition. That's why for that reason, nag-struggle siya. In fact, sa ato karon, no? Naamang yun. Na individually, we really experience from day to day, gakadaiyang ng mga struggle, gakadaiyang ng mga pulling up, pulling down, mga pressures, forces. That's why, but you know, unsay nakamotivate kang Paul. Si Paul Magod is, nalang isa giyagian ng experiences sa Ginoo. No? Nalang isa giyagian. And continuously, he's so vocal, he's so certain, no? Sa iyang kanabitang tawag sa Ginoo. He was so kanabitang convinced sa iyang pagkaila sa Ginoo. Ito wala na ilay, di ba? Ingong kadiri, abilidad, uyaw si Paul, no? Men teachers, legalistic teachers, no? Kanabitang, kanaginayon nga, legalistic righteousness. Kabalo siya, anak, no? So, grabe ang iyan, kung nga say, ingong pa niya sa other ng mga kanabitang mga declarations, ingon niya, kung nga mo ika boast about, I have more. Ingon niya, kung proud ka mo niya, napakoy ka proud. But ingon pa niya nga, but I consider all of these things as waste just to know resurrection power of the Lord Jesus Christ ang ginabuhay. So yun nga ang iyong declaration. So kanina itong pag-isgutan ko ron, we talk about kanabi itong katuyuhan ni Paul, anong bisulti niya. So there are mga goals, katuyuhan si Paul sa church, sa policy. Yung nga niya, okay, so verse 1, I want you to know how much I am struggling for you and for those in Laodicea and for all who have not met me personally. Okay, in verse 2, my purpose is that they may be encouraged in heart and united in love so that they may have the full riches of complete understanding in order that they may know the mystery of God, namely Christ. Okay? Now, naitulog ang aspekto ng iyang isgutan diri in this verse 2. Ingon niya din eh, that they may be encouraged in heart. So, kapag naman tao sa niya word niya encourage. So, kung tanawin mo na sa kanabitang dictionary, kanang word niya encourage, it talks about giving support. How do we encourage? Giving support. No? Strengthening. No? Speaking the word. Especially the word that the Lord is putting into your heart for somebody else. Just like itong ganina, itong ibuat. No? This is a manifestation that what Paul is really wanting for the body to really do. Okay? For the building of the body. Okay? So, mo lang yung picture out. So, alam na nato ng Hebrews chapter 10, verses 24 to 25. Hebrews 10, 24 to 25. Okay. Okay. And let us consider how we may spur one another on love and good deeds. Let us not give up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. Yung pagdiyak sa akong understanding, so that no one will be left behind. Muna akong ginastorya sa akong mga bata. Yan ang pag-studio, pag-studyan din ako sila para wala yung mabagsak. Muna ginihingan ako so that no one will be left behind. Now, in this, kanyang din pag-illustrate that the day approaching. When the Lord, kabalo mo ta, this is our hope. No? Mabon niya itong hope? Mabon niya itong hope na si Jesus will come for the second time. Dili na pagluwas, no, papatap siya yung kinabuhi, kay humanan ang bibuhay. Ba't pagkuha katong nagatuo kaniya. Kita nga nagpabiling, nga matinudanon kaniya, this is the time. This is the day. That's why Paul is keep encouraging, no, nga magpadayon ta, mag-encourage ta sa matag-usa. No? So, mo na ang iyang inasulti direk sa Hebrews chapter 10. Encourage one another. And all the more as you see the day approaching. Now, the specific niya today is, let us not give up meeting together. As some are in the habit of doing. So, the habit na nila, no? Mag-meet yun sila. Kaya itong giya, we meet na lagi. Tayo na mga niluloy, ni Philip, ni Hilda. No? Nag-copy-copy mo dito. And so, ganun. So, in the same manner, you do the same, no? Dili na to niya siya kanang ikalimtan. Let us not give up meeting together. No, dili lang kada Sunday. No, I would like to tell you ang klarong experiences sa to ang kanang ginatawag na to experience or knowledge sa Ginoo. Kanang naata sa mga atong individual na to ng mga kanabitaw mga concern. How do we handle our concern? Diya nimo ma-encounter ang mga kanabitaw pagkamaayo sa Ginoo sa atong kinabuhi. Mga fulfillment sa mga saad sa atong kinabuhi. You know, there's one thing na akong experience. And I always do this with all my heart. That's why I would like to borrow the word struggling to do this. Kaya ikaw mag-spend time ka sa Ginoo. Kaya ikaw mag-spend time sa Ginoo. Dagang kayo kuha na na. Kaya ng babak. No? Because kabalo kayo ko, kabalo kayo ta, when we come into the presence of the Lord, something new will happen. Something new will come and will happen. Ingon pa din, ingon pa sa ako sa Ginoo, when I come unto the Lord, things will happen. And if, kung sa mga things will happen, or pagtanong ng tumor ko aman, but truly, naagyoy na hitabo. That's why, as sa kadayang sa diyan ako nag-spend time sa Ginoo, no? The Lord says, standing in your presence, Lord, I started to make declaration. No? In your presence, Lord, I see freedom. Dakan mo kahit mga mong istorya na rin, di ba? So there is some freedom. Lord, in your presence, I find refuge, rest to my soul. No? Kaya dakan kahit mga concern. Okay? So, matapusan na ito, dakan kahit concern. Day to day, we are bombarded with several concerns. And thank you, and to tell you, kaniyang concern are not kanang invalid. They are valid concerns. But how do we handle this concern? Yung kadaiya, degree of the importance, the degree of how it affects us, how we shake us. No? Asawa ka, naakay concern sa mong pamilya, bala ka, naakay concern sa mong pamilya, trabaho, naakay concerns, and so on. Taghan. But I know, and this is one thing that I would like to share to you. Just give time. Ng mga tutadya sa presensya sa Ginoo. Kada adlaw. Morgan na ato ang kanang mahimo. Na klaro yun, na there is something that will happen. Diba, yung katong last na time na nag-share ko, diba nahimong ko nga, anate inahimong nga, 6, 9, 12, 3, 6, na matampo sa Ginoo. Ang ato mga exon mo sa dibuhat pa, similar to this. Inyat kita pa, na klaro magiging ang ato ang ipadulingan.
Amen.
Klaro magiging ang ato ang disamputan. In fact, we are His manifestation. Even by the church is where the manifold wisdom of God will be revealed. No? Naisa na ko ka amigo ng structural engineer. Share siya sa iyang asawa. Ang bagla, ngayon may share niya sa sarapo niya. Pag-ara na itaktaan, mutaan ako, Brother Louis, nag-pray siya sa ako. And so, na-encounter na po ngayon yung need na itong lalaki, itong amigo na ito. Ngayon asawa daw, this time, kaya nabitong magdamgog. Unya, anong, iyadong damgog, kaya nabitong magnaan siya sa past na panahon. And then, pag humang doon ang damgog, ng mata siya, grabe daw kakapoy iyang ma-feel. No? Ma-weaken daw siya ba? Niya, yung pa niya sa ako, nga, kuhaan ka ng ako kung gawin na ako, sir, nga, ako siyang, asa kong dadkoon kay Manambalan, gano'ng nga na ba? Ako siyang i-street yung nag-store. Ayaw na, kay Dili na pamahagi sa Ginoo. And kabulog ka John, yun na yung pangalan. Kabulog ka John, si Kristo Jesus lang yun. Ang restore, mo-deliver ka sa iya at yun. Ay, cancer, gano'ng cancer, dagang it's a prison. And sa diyan, ato na, kung sa kanon sa man, kaya nang ato nang kuhan, limit nang ito yung Mrs. Sheila. Ang sabi buhat ko, sir, ang buhan na ito. Kaya sabi mo, ang buhan, sir. Ako. Ano na rin siya na, ako sa nakainuglugan, sir. Ako sa nakainuglugan. Ako sa nakainuglugan. Ito yung glass nga itik sa ako. Inuglugan ako na, sir. Ito na, brave niluloy nga. Brave yun na, ibabagan. Ano ang gila? Kasi itong buhat kong share, share na po ang word sa inyo. No? I would like to say, dili ako ang pulong-pulong nga akong ginasulti. Natibig ngayon, understanding. Let the word of God be spoken. Because the Word of God has power to release anybody. In fact, di ba, mga nang ingon ni Jesus, I came, di ba, the Spirit of the Lord has come upon me, set you free, brokenhearted, di ba? That is, mga nang ingon din. So, matay ang Spirit. Okay, so, ingon din ang, let us continuously come sa presensya sa Ginoo. Aron nato ma-experience more and more ang ato ang breakthrough. Now, next is Romans double. Romans chapter 1, verses 11 to 20. And it talks about the word of encouragement. Yeah. Ingin niya, I long to see you so that I may impart to you some spiritual gift to make you strong. Verse 12. That is, that you and I may be mutually encouraged by each other's faith. You see?
Kita na do? Hamatag pagtuon nato, magtabang one another. Mutual. There's only, it's not one direction. But there's also coming back.
In fact, ingon diya nga, I need your encouragement. You need my encouragement too. And then, just like again, what we have done just few minutes ago.
And then, money ang ginayon niya, can I pray you?
Let's pray together.
Those are the things nga, naga point us to this word of encouragement.
Napatay na daw,
eh? Amen.
Next, kining yung next nga statement there is, united in love. No? Ingon niya din he, that they may be encouraged in heart, and then the next, and they will be united in love. What does the body of Christ looks like? Being united in love. Relating to one another as a family. No? Pamilya man ta.
So, establish that gun. Mag-care ta ba? Kung sa may ato. Kung sa may ako ang matabang. You see? Kung sa may kuhan. Kung sa may, how can I help you? No? Ako na to?
When we come into the presence of the Lord,
di ba, hindi na, kung sa man ang simbahan. No? Ang simbahan sa Ginoo, the body of Christ, which we are a member, adun na tayo role.
The eye cannot see to the ears, I do not need you. The hands cannot say to the feet, I don't need you. We are part of the body. And the wonderful things here is that as we do our part, yan ang giingon dyan sa Ginoo nga, the manifold wisdom of God will be revealed. Another term there is kind of ito, the excellencies of God will be revealed, will be displayed. Hallelujah. It will be displayed as we come together.
So, dili lang kami ni Luloy, ni Hilda, ni Philip. Kitang tanan. Let us find time to meet together
as the day approaches. No?
Okay, so, that's it. Mutually encouraged. It's not one direction, it's a two-way direction of encouraging one another.
And then, united in love. No? Showing support for one another. No? Showing support. And these are expressions of love.
Ingon pa diya, how do we love?
When do we show our love?
No?
Kanang showing love to each other, to each one, is an expression.
No? Kanang ito, aron mamayo imo ang piling. Kaya imo man gigugma imong ipso.
It's not just that. Showing love is actually a declaration that I am in obedience to the call of God sa akong ginabuhi. And to each one of us. Maingon pa din sa John, I cannot remember the verse, but the word says, if you obey, kanang ingon niya nga, John chapter, batayin nga niya niya nga, ingon niya nga word niya nga, kanabitaw, He is the one who loves me. If you love me, you will obey what I command. He who loves me will be loved by my Father. Tanang mga nana sa chapter 14. And I will ask the Father. No, it's not that. So, kana siya. If you love me, you will obey what I command. What you will obey what I command. Okay, ito. Whoever has my commands and obeys them, he is the one who loves me. He who loves me will be loved by my Father. And I too will love him and show myself to him. Okay? So, this is a very clear declaration of the word. Show that love sa matag-isa. We are in obedience to the call and pinapitang sugot sa Ginoon sa itong pinabuhi. Next, 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 8. 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 8. Above all, love each other deeply because love covers over a multitude of sins. Deeply. Love each other deeply. How do we show that? Kanang deep yun nga concern. Deep na love. How do we show that? More than sa kanang ganahan lang. No? Hindi yung ganahan. No? It's beyond the kanang ganagana. In fact, what should remain should be the understanding of the word. I was called to do that, then the rest sa Ginoo, ako ginabuha to. Okay? We are not being influenced by simply what we feel. But we are being influenced by the word sa Ginoo. Amen ba? Okay. Then the third intention of Paul. To the Church of Colossae, to the Church of CLC, Davao. Ingon niya, so that they may have the full riches of complete understanding. So that they may have the full riches of complete understanding. And then, ingon niya din kita balikan itu kan chapter 2 verse 2 Colossians 2:2 My purpose is that they may be encouraged in heart and united in love so that they may have the full riches of complete understanding in order that they may know the mystery of God, namely Christ, that they may be okay? So complete understanding, so that they may have the full riches of complete understanding. What's so meaning complete understanding? That they may have the complete understanding. Sa laing nga mga version sa Biblia, ang isulti ni parallel ni full assurance of understanding. Full assurance of understanding. Unsa man ang magbabag sa tua from getting a full assurance of understanding or dili na to ma-experience kanang level nga having complete understanding. Number one, ignorance of the word of God.
kita na to. Importante yun.
But we always have the time to meditate, to read, to study the Word of God. Okay? Next, unbelief. When we choose not to obey the Word. Okay? And then the third is when we are deceived. Deception. The third is deception. Okay? Complete understanding or full assurance of understanding dili nato makabot when we have these three things. Ignorance of the Word of God. Sila lang na magbabasa sa pulong sa Ginoo. Magaduel sa pulong sa Ginoo. When we also choose to believe. So, unbelief. And unbelief, yung pati ang is a sin. When we are living a life of sin, when we allow sin to enter and to control us, surely we will never attain a full assurance of understanding sa ato at yes. And then deception. Again, deception is when we are short of understanding. So, pwede ka na masway-sway. Okay? So, you notice, in fact, munang obserbahan na ito, kabaluta, na gagadahiyan, na karadakan tayo mga kuwan, mga pagtulungan. No? Kaya iskwilahan, agang kayo. Dili man siguro resulti, pero bidisplay na sa iyang pinabuhi ka na mapagtulungan. Makita na po ng dagang kayo sa Yusuf, mga bata. Ikadahiya. No? Katong pizza 23 na. Ako amang birthday. No? Mayo 23. Oo. Oh. Hindi, siyempre, na-busy yung may accreditation na. Yeah, ako may head sa electrical. So, ako may pangutang nun. So, wala ako kabalo ba? Ano, mata? Pero, panahala ako mga estudyante, katong ako ang ikuan sa ako sa ginawang gin-trust ba ng mga pinabuhi. Ganaan na sila tayo na may gamay mong sulod dito sa putahan. Para sa tanong ko, sabi tuyo na nila, na, isa tayo ninyo, sabi ko, ano na, isa aran ko, ano ba? Yung was ko. So, sir, nang tamo ituyo, sir, katong isa. Yung isa kaya, ano, disciple dito na. Nang tamo ituyo, sir, kung sabi tuyo ninyo, kasi dito lang tayo, mag-istorya siya. Nakudiri lang, hindi ka. Sus, nag-ready mo like cake. No? Kaya di kong taganaan lang cake. Imagine. No? Taganaan ko lang cake. Ano na? Nakabulo ko siya gisulti sa cake. Happy birthday, Tatay Rene. Uy! Hallelujah. Nagpagawa ko ba? That's how they look at me. I mean, and then, ako yung band dito, wala dito sa nakikmeet sa ako, no? Mga civil engineering, no? Mga, some of them are mga kakuha ni Lulu, eh, mga JTs, civil engineering, no? They just simply come to me. And ako yung isang mining. Yeah.
Doon siya, and then, mga yung kamot. Yeah, yan na. No? Tawa na, hanap ako. Si Lulo ay tagaan ko niya kay Bia, Iblis na bro. Every time I'm Iblis. Ang kami na siya. Ang ala. No? So si kita ng mga bata. Nagkaroon ng kukuhan ba? Nagkaroon ng rakog ngayon. Kaya kung ba? No? And then I listen to their cries, to their need. Broken family, wala nang buwag yung mga papa, so na-touch ko. Kasi tignan mo that ang need, even in your own domain, in your own area where the Lord has placed you, there is kakang need yet. And you need to listen what the Lord is telling you to happen mo. Akan. Ako, man. Ako, may irritate ganito ka na ng taong. Pero itong, kanyang hundaan dapat buhat, hindi buhat pa lang niya. Okay? And then, okay, kaya, pwede ko siya'y blind yun. No? Kung siya'y, from doing what is supposed to be done. Ganoon siya. And so, again, and you know, kanang ang mga gina-project, pagkampong 6, 9, 12, 3, 6. Grabe ganoon ang pay mo. Lahit ba? So the Lord is just reminding you to pray for peace. Ano na po? Masahit siya, magpapirma ko siya. Yeah, alam ako. Ito sa akong pipikil. Pagyahan ka nila ganyan. So ganoon ba? So, and this is one thing akong ipasa sa akong mga bata. Just give 15 minutes. Teach to it again. Pwede mo diri, o pwede dito sa taas. Ang dili mo ma-disturb ko. You pray. So, praise God. No? And, okay? So what full assurance looks like? Romans 8:38-39. Mao na niya maghatag nato pinabitong kaligun in terms of full assurance. 38:39. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers. Verse 39. Neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Nothing can separate us. Nothing. Tingnan mo ka kayo mo. Nothing.
Nothing
can separate us from the love of God. Okay? So this is one thing, no? Maka-build up sa itong assurance, again. The love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And then you have this Colossians chapter 2 verse 4. Colossians chapter 2 verse 4. I tell you this so that no one may deceive you by fine sounding arguments. Okay? Ano na yung mga grupo na trying to deceive the believers in policy? Okay? John chapter 16, verses 13 and 14. But when He, the Spirit of truth, comes, He will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on His own. He will speak only what He hears. And He will tell you what is yet to come. Verse 14. He will bring glory to Me by taking from what is Mine and making it known to you. In verse 3 of Colossi, Colossians chapter 2 verse 3, Colossians chapter 2 verse 3, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. Kinsa asa ni siya? Kinsa ang source ani? Kung Jesus.
Amen.
Mao na ang iyang kwaon, katong gibasa ito nga, John 16 verse 14, iyan pa, the word of the Spirit is iyan kwaon kung unsan big na sa ako and that it revealed sa inyo. Ingon pa niya na let us not be swayed by an expression of our deep. Makong ito ang dito na nota na kapukos sa itong mga gasa. Okay. No? Yan ang mga gift na ito, it's okay. But the central picture of this is actually to Jesus.
Amen.
To Jesus, yun ang center.
Amen.
So He will bring glory to me by taking from what is mine and making it known to you. No? The hidden treasures, all of the treasures of wisdom and knowledge na atang Jesus, kunya iyan ang kwaon sa Spirit sa Ginoo, i-reveal sa matag-usa natin. Can you imagine? That is wonderful. Okay? And then in verse 5, Colossians chapter 2, verse 5. Tingnan niya, Paul was pleased to see how orderly you are. Orderly. And how firm your faith in Christ is. Ito ang kaputan. Tingnan niya, how orderly you are. Ito na ang order. Ito ang basahan ng 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 33. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 33. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 33. For God is not a God of disorder, but of peace. So gusto sa Ginoo, order, kanang word na order is an opposite to confusion. Confusion, another term of disorder is confusion. No? I-confuse ka, so ma-disorder na ka. Okay? So, ang katuyuan sa Ginoo is always to have it peace, order. Order. So, yung ni Paul din, yung gina-desire na how orderly you are. He's talking on the policy. And this is also what we are trying also to see sa ito ang mga kinabuhi, no? This body. Okay? And then, yun niya, how firm your faith in Christ is. See, look at 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 13. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be men of courage. Be strong. So the word stand firm in the faith. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be men of courage. Be strong. And then, tingnan niya sa 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 8 to 9. Be self-controlled and alert. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Verse 9. Resist him, standing firm in the faith, because you know that your brothers throughout the world are undergoing the same kind of suffering. Okay? So the word here, stand firm in the faith. Resistance, standing firm in the faith. And then, Isaiah 7, verse 9. Isaiah 7, verse 9. Okay? The head of Ephraim is Samaria, and the head of Samaria is only Remaliah's son. If you do not stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. Balikan ako, if you do not stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. So we need to be strengthened in our faith. And how do we do that? When I get in there, faith comes from hearing, and hearing for the word of God. What else? Stay in the Word. What else? Stay connected to the body of Christ. Hindi po siya naman ka, usa lang ka, maglatagaw. You need to be connected. No, na ako na reference ala na sa Psalms. Diba? Dili daw ka mamunga kung dili ka ang mong root na ka tanong yun. No? Isa na siya nga kung sa Psalms chapter 1. No? He who dwells in that chapter 1, Psalms chapter 1. Okay? That's how important it is
to be connected to the body of Christ. Okay? Before the altar, before. See, before pa. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the way of sinners, or sit in the seat of mockers. Next. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. Verse 3. He is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does, prospers. Okay? So, kita ninyo ang importansya. Stay connected to the body of Christ. And then, be praying about areas of your life. You know, the Holy Spirit has shown you in the past. Ano yung mga kaginayon ba? Weaknesses. Take note of that. Be on guard. No? Kung ginapakita ito sa Ginoon sa mga ibang ginabuhi, take note of that. Okay? Keep an eye on those areas in your life. Keep an eye. Okay, whatever is that. Lord, I need you all the time. I need you. Keep me strong in my faith, in my confidence in you, in my delighting always in you. Strengthen me by your word. Let this be our prayer. Amen.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord, for your word. And mahan ko at mapagampong you draw lang yun me, matapos siya. Lord, naghan kayong mga masurpay sa mga pamunangna, ang mga feelings, ang mga concerns. But Lord, I thank you. Lord, kanang last week, kanang mundool ang yun sa inyo, mga Father, Lord, we find refuge. We find strength. We find freedom. We find victory. Father, I thank you. Salamat sa inyong word. And bless you.